Hold on a sec. I'll get it.
Deke, you there?
Boozer. Hell aren't you in your damn... bunk.
I couldn't sleep. You remember what I said back in the tunnel? Don't go up there, Nate. It's making you crazy.
Boozer, I go up there because there's freaks up there. I kill them here, I kill them there. Bounties are all the same.
Then what are the tulips for, huh? I saw them, Deke. Here on the table. This morning. The same one she had at the wedding. I remember.
Fucking up.
Listen, Boozer.
Get some rest. I gotta go. Deacon out.
Help.
John, we got a job for you.
Hey, Tucker. Okay, I'll stop by when I can. Deacon out.
Damn it. What, are you waiting to jump me? Huh?
Deacon St. John, this is Tucker. Like I said before, I haven't seen Boozer Sweetface around these last few days. You sure he's all right?
This is Deacon. Boozer's fine. Like I said, he's just been busy.
Doing runs for that son of a bitch Mark Copeland, no doubt. I get the feeling he doesn't like me much. Boozer, I mean.
Like I said, I ain't his old lady, Deacon out.
They got him! They got him!
We
lost someone!
That son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
Okay, let's take a look around. Okay, here we go. Need this?
There he is! Silver helmet, red gas tank. That's him.
Oh, shit! What the hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out with you. Just chop you.
Don't let him get away, Deke.
Suck on it, you hear me? Hey, no.
Yeah, well, Coke kind of frowns on that. Not a fan of it myself, if you want to know the truth. Give drifters a bad name. What if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You want to cope with Stoney's, you little bitch! That's what you are, you little bitch!
Cope, it's done. Got him.
You tell him.
Mark down these coordinates and send your men out here.
You hear me?
Good.
Is he alive?
Hey, Drifter. Drifter.
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's going to stay that way. Beacon out.
You tell him, Drifter. You tell him I said to go screw himself.
Boozer, you there? I was just calling a checkup on you.
Yeah, Dean, come here.
You hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said. Work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out. Fix this. Good. Oh, here we go. Done. Just gotta close my eyes for a bit. That should do it.
get in there.
Mind if I do?
Hey,
it's all of them.
Jesus.
Who was that?
You're seeing things. It wasn't around here.
Men coming! Fire! We got him!
Saw someone out there.
What do you think now, huh? Somebody shoots back. How do you like that?
The last of them.
Saw something.
Coming!
Move it back! Get down!
Hold still, Cutler!
Take us down!
You can't hide, you son of a bitch!
Saw something.
Go. Now I got
you. They're hit.
Move. I got you.
Shut up.
Down.
That's it. You're done. How do you like that, huh? Being ambushed, you like that? You murdering sons of bitches.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's something, Cope. Law and order are a thing of the past. What the hell are you talking about? But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force.
and a lot of goddamn ammo.
I wonder if they had a bunker around here.
Bet they do. Here's the hatch. Yeah, no, you had one. Looks like they marked it up good. Got some papers, notes on crafting. Yeah.
mass grave. Why'd they bury this shit out here again? Oh, yeah, because they're assholes. How do I get in there?
Open.
Come on.
Okay.
Bunch of murderers and vagrants. We'd just as soon shoot you as look at you. Oh.
Somebody's trapped. They gotta help.
Help! Help! I need help!
I got this.
Hang on. You wanna die out here? Look, there's a camp in
there. Camp? Where? Where? Show me. I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
I was done for. Holy shit! No! Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Oh, man.
Name's Deacon. They know who I am.
Stay off the main roads. Don't stop.
More ammo.
Learn something new every day.
Hey, Deke.
Manny.
Wait a sec, I got it.
Yeah, got some good stuff in stock.
Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life.
Be here.
No, I'll keep an eye out for more shit.
We'll be see you around next time.
Ran into a pack of nice dogs, wolves, whatever the hell they are. Runners.
I was on this crappy bike, falling apart. Freaks ain't gonna mess with you now.
Couldn't outrun them. They were snapping at me, running alongside. I swear they were trying to knock
all right
me off, working together. Barely got away.
All right.
Enough to give you nightmares.
Wait a sec, I got it.
During the American Revolution, when we were fighting for our freedoms, we gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. A right we used to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. When all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this, I'm gonna take a
bet those who survived were those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away from me.
I got a use for you.
Open up. I've got all day.
Hold on. I know. Open up. That's it.
Can I help you?
Hey, what's up?
We're gonna run out of this someday, you know. Okay, then. See you later.
How you doing? What's happening?
All right. I see how it is. Okay.
Boozer said you guys are, thinking about heading north.
Yeah. As soon as we put together enough gear, we're riding out of here. Tucker's starting to get him.
Mm. See you
again. Got something to say about it.
It smells like rotten
eggs. That's all I got for now.
Get used to it. Right now it's all we got.
Hey, what do you need?
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, I'll be back.
Can I help you?
Deke, you ever ride with a drifter, scars all over his face, carries a tire iron, goes by the name of Limbo?
Don't know him.
He came into camp yesterday to turn in some bounties, have a few drinks. Seems like he didn't leave until early this morning.
Well, Tuck, I don't run security here, so why don't you just tell Alki about that?
He beat a man, Deke, and a woman, to death. Bowman and Hewitt. Her face was so smashed in, you couldn't tell it was her.
Hewitt. Oh, Maria. Right? Jesus. This asshole, Limbo. He's a local.
Alki says they've set up shop at the old Forest Service watchtower on the east slope of Three Finger Jack.
Yep, I know where it is, and, I'll handle it.
I thought you might.
Hey, Tuck. So, am I on your trust list or no?
You here for your bike?
Hey, what's going on?